Hello everybody. So I think today we're just going to do some flake points. It's going to be a lot of pressure, maybe some indirect, and we'll see how many we can get done today. Only got 40 minutes, probably more like 35 now, but we'll see what we can do. I don't do much napping over the weekend. And this last weekend, I went ahead and tried to put some extra time in, just try to make some stuff, and I had a horrible day of napping. I just could not get the mahogany obsidian to behave. I broke so many pieces. And then when you break it, you get frustrated, and you break it more, and then... So, I got a few pieces I want to try to play around with. And we'll just see if we can make some small, thin arrowheads. Maybe some small Desert Sierras, or maybe an Eastgate, Columbia Plateau, possibly. Let's see. We'll see. Mahogany Obsidian and I have not been getting along lately. But there's plenty here to play with. A lot of times with flakes, you're not going to get a flake pattern all the way across because you just don't have the thickness to get across there. And it was pretty common to find points with one side or the other not fully cleared. So we're just going to get cracking at it and see what we can make. Beauty is it's already thin, so now it's just shape, sharpen, and notch. That's at least the theory. However, I've broken my fair share of just about everything, so I like to rough up the edges so I don't cut myself. It also knocks off any of the pieces that may have fractured. And then what I like to do is go for the thickest mass, which is right in here. So we're gonna raise our platform. We got a bump here. We'll probably just eat this whole bottom in and go that route. But we got a lot to take off of here. Probably bring this whole side in. Make this the tip. I may establish the tip first just so I can kind of think in terms of centerline and symmetry, I think is what I'll do. More than likely, I'll just pop that tip off. So we'll see what happens. I think we'll start on the bottom end here. You gotta really be careful with your squeeze and how much pressure you put in the middle, because you'll break this right in half. I've definitely broken quite a few pieces. We've got length and thickness on this, so length and thickness. So we'll see what happens. Let's see how quick we can get this one done. Oops.
It's okay.
We need to pull it in anyway. Pop the tip off. Yeah, I am. It got me into. The tip was a little thin anyway. So we'll see if we can. Dang! Come on now. I just broke it again. Too much Hercules, I guess. I don't know. Did a point trade with Billy Berger a while back, a long time ago, and he sent me some obsidian points that were just ridiculously thin. And I'm sitting here just trying to figure out how the hell guy's got some wicked skills. Really nice guy. I've talked to him a few times. Very nice. Friendly guy. Alright, so now let's try to fix, actually get an arrowhead shape here. Let's see here. We bring. Let's see. The tip is diving down. So if we scoop out this. Okay. Maybe I'll do a little corner notch. Here's the rough shape. Before I go too far, I want to get my notches in. So here's your rough shape. Rough shape. So we're going to go ahead and try throwing in some corner notches. And then we'll do some edge cleanup. And we'll call this one a good notch. The notches. Oh no, that one needs to go a little deeper. I got excited. Yeah, that one's off just a little. My little bone tool here. See if we can clean it up a little bit. tip is diving straight down. I gotta clean that up. There, that's a little better. Angle was off on my notches a little bit, but here's what we come up with. Really quite thin. You can kind of see the original flake surface. But it is pretty flat. See if we can do a rotation here. I messed up on the angle of one of my notches. One's a little steeper, one's a little bit more open. That's why it looks a little funky. But I'm gonna leave it alone. Okay, there's that one. Let's try another one. Yeah, another 20 minutes. See if we can bust out another flake spot. See what we got here. Doo-doo-doo. About this one. Pretty flat. So let's see. I'd love to make a Columbia Plateau out of this, or maybe a Humboldt would look nice. Elko. Elko would be awesome. It's got plenty of thickness. That'd be pretty cool if I could pull that off. I'll probably snap it in half, though. Going after the thick spots first. It's got very thin edges. I don't think I'm going to be able to do an Elko. But we can see what we can do. I should probably get out the indirect, but I think I'm going to just pressure flake it. At least try to. So I think we can do it. Try and get my center line here a little bit nicer. Might do make this the base, maybe. And then pull this in to make the tip. That would make the most sense. So let's see what we can do here. Possibly. Squeezed it too hard. What do we want to try now? Can't believe they're gonna. New plan. That's two. I don't know if there was any leaf shaped obsidian points. I'd have to look. New approach here. So we're gonna go like this. So I think what I'm gonna make is a cascade, which is like a, looks like a football. So that's what I'm gonna try to do. Now I'm just gonna work on symmetry. Here's where we're at. It's gonna be a little bit wider than a normal, I think, cascade, but I wanna save as much pretty color as possible. We got good evenness. So now it's just cleaning it up, making it look like I know what I'm doing. Which is sometimes easier said than done. Cascades. The cascade's kind of a brilliant point type. I mean, you're tapering both ends, so you get all sorts of time to thin. It's pretty smart. Now, if you're somebody like me that likes to break tips, like I just did again, I had the symmetry the way I wanted it. I just had to fuss with the tip like an idiot. Just couldn't leave it alone. I had to fuss with it. If anything, this will make a nice pendant piece. Let's see what a cascade looks like. Oh, it's significantly skinnier. Let's see what we got here. That's time. Let's see what we got here. Cascade. So I got a chunky cascade. You can see they get pretty big. Basically, it's just a football. Well, one end is broader than the other, it looks like. So, here's my version. This is more like a leaf point, possibly. But I think I got the symmetry pretty decent. It's got pretty good thickness. I think it's only about 3/16, maybe an eighth. Get a little closer for you guys here. It's got beautiful color. You can see there's some shimmer in the orange. It has some translucency. There's a piece of ash or impurity right here. Yeah. And then you drop it, you know. Mess everything up. There we go. I might wrap this as a pendant. Because that's pretty cool material. Alrighty, well, we got two done today. I'd say not too bad. Well, thanks for watching.